Ukrainian authorities saying they seized 154 assets from the detained Ukrainian opposition politician and Putin ally, Viktor Medvedchuk. That includes 26 cars for one guy, 30 plots of land, 23 houses for one guy, 32 apartments, and a yacht. Medvedchuk is believed to be one of the richest people in Ukraine, also has deep personal ties to Vladimir Putin. Now, Putin himself has acknowledged that the two know each other very well. You just have to take this one crucial fact. Putin is the godfather of Medvedchuk's daughter. Out front now, Stanislav Kucher. He is a Russian television journalist who left the country because he could no longer do his job as a journalist there. And Louisa Kroll, the executive editor of Forbes, which has done extensive reporting on the oligarchs, Russian, Ukrainian, and others. So, Louisa, this asset seizure is pretty stunning. I'll say it again. 26 cars, 30 plots of land, 23 houses, 32 apartments, and a yacht. This seems like a very big victory for the Ukrainians.
Well, I mean, I think it's a victory. I mean, the fact that he's under house arrest again, that's a bigger victory. The fact that he would never have had access to any of those assets right now anyway. But yes, it's definitely something that Zelensky and Ukraine can point to. And of course, they've been trying to use that as a bargaining chip with Putin, though that seems to have failed, you know, at least for now.
So Stanislav, the Kremlin says Putin and Medvedchuk never had any, quote, behind the scenes relations. That seems to be just patently false. It's not just all these pictures I'm putting up four times. We could find them together. That's four of many. And Putin is Medvedchuk's daughter's godfather. We know that because Putin told that to Oliver Stone, right? So we know that as a fact. What can you tell us about Medvedchuk, someone I know you've covered?
Well, yes, Erin. The thing is that Medvedchuk is the way to pronounce his last name, although there are many in Russia who still make mistakes. Medvedchuk is the guy who is considered by a lot of Russians and Ukrainians as the great master of con, as a great master of grift, as somebody, you know, who has always positioned himself as, you know, the guy who solves problems and the guy who controls everything in Ukraine. And that's probably his greatest asset as far as, again, he has positioned himself. And that, at the same time, is turning out to be the greatest drawback about him now, because mm-hmm. he had numerously informed Putin and his entourage that the Ukraine is, again, under his control, under the control of his friends, oligarchs, that he can solve any problem in Ukraine, and that if Russia enters Ukraine, if Russia invades Ukraine, then a lot of Ukrainian entrepreneurs, business people will just welcome an invasion like that. And so right now, what I hear from my sources in Moscow is that the Kremlin is very, very irritated, to put it mildly, with the information, or should I say misinformation, that Medvedchuk had provided them with for years.
All right, so that it's all been a fraud. So, you know, forget the whole godfather thing. Putin's certainly not going to step in here. It seems to be the bottom line, Stanislav.
Well, exactly. The thing is, there is something you should understand about Vladimir Putin. You know, whether he was Medvedchuk's youngest daughter's godfather or not, Medvedchuk is just an asset for Putin. People are assets for Vladimir Putin. He exploits people. So as far as loyalty is concerned, if you're speaking about loyalty, you know, whether Medvedchuk can be so precious to Putin just because Putin had once been his daughter's godfather, no. Putin wants people to be loyal to him, but he doesn't believe he should be that loyal to people
anyone.
Solely because they were once close together.
So, Louisa, obviously, Medvedchuk, now that Stanislav has made the pronunciation clear, is obviously a Ukrainian oligarch with deep loyalties to Putin. But you have all the oligarchs now, the seizures happening such that they can, right? Because these guys are the masters of hiding money. But German officials, Louisa, say they've now seized the world's largest yacht. It's a 512 feet. It's called the Dilbar, owned by one of the richest oligarchs in Russia. Alisher Usmanov. Yep. That yacht, I understand, is valued up to $750 million. 82-foot swimming pool, which is the biggest on any yacht. It's got a garden, two helipads, all that sort of stuff. This is happening. And I know, Luis, it gives people around the world some sense of that it's righteous that these things are occurring. But at this point, is there any pressure that this sort of stuff puts on Putin himself?
Well, I think just as my colleague was saying, not at all. He doesn't really care much about these oligarchs, or at least ones like Usmanov. I mean, I think he's going to let them, you know, kind of, you know, wallow or whatever in the wind, and he's not too concerned. I certainly have not seen much pressure or any kind of reaction from Putin about these, you know, yachts and stuff. I mean, he's more concerned about the commodities that are being sanctioned, et cetera. You know, Usmanov, you know, by the way, you know, he had transferred ownership of these assets of Dilbar and a yacht and a plane to his sister a couple of years ago, as though he was expecting something like this to happen. So, you know, whether or not this is really going to stop the lifestyles of these people, you know, is not clear either, as many of them start to look for other places that they can move. So I don't think...
As I said, there's kind of a righteousness in it, but that may not be matched by the reality of the impact in any regard. Thank you both so very much. I appreciate your time.